I'm always fascinated by artificial intelligence ever since I was a little kid. I'm just amazed at the fact that we can make robots, we can make machines to do what human beings do, and it's just so cool, you know, just to watch that happen. So I like reading about stuff like that and, you know, seeing that. And it amazes me that human beings are able to be that creative, that we could image God in a certain way by creating something as cool as robots. Of course, we know that machines come with their own downsides. You know, they've caused a lot of troubles in our society as well. But no matter how good a robot is, no matter how good a machine is, no matter what task it performs, one thing that a robot is always going to lack is what philosophers call qualia, and that's consciousness. Right? The robot is never going to be conscious of the fact that they're doing what they're doing. And in a sense, I think that's what makes us different from robots, from machines. Because God, the greatest gift God has ever given you and I, is the gift of free will. In fact, some theologians would argue that free will is how we image God. Free will is how we be like God, that we're able to choose one or the other. And we see how our readings today, especially our first reading and our gospel, presents this whole issue of choice, of free will. Joshua, you know, makes it to the Holy Land, to Canaan with the Israelites. Moses couldn't make it. Now he gives them a choice. Folks, you have to decide now if you're going to serve the God of your fathers, the same God who brought you out of Egypt, or if you're going to worship the gods of the Perizzites, the Ammonites, of these pagans, you know, the Baars of that territory. Of course, the people are like, far from it that we worship any other god than Hashem. You know, Yahweh, the God of Israel. So, you know, Joshua tells him, he's a jealous God, just so you know. You know, he's not going to tolerate you worshiping another God. But this whole concept of choice is presented to them. It's up to you if you want to serve this God who has been so gracious to you, who has been so good. And now we find in our gospel reading today, John chapter 6, the Bread of Life discourse. In this chapter, Jesus has said a lot of difficult things for the Jews to handle. You know, he's saying, you know, I'm bread that came down from heaven. And I'm thinking, those of us who are living now are trying to convince the world that Jesus is truly present in the Eucharist. So you can imagine Jesus trying to convince folks around him that he's a bread. Like, we see you, folk, you know, we see you, you're a human being, and you're telling me you're a bread come down from heaven. In fact, we know where you were born. You're a carpenter's son. You know, so it would be very hard for them to take this. And we're told that even his disciples, some of his disciples, went back to their former way of life because they could not take this scandal anymore. Why would Jesus say he is the bread and is come to give eternal life? But Jesus presents again the choice to the 12, because the 12 did not go with the other disciples. He asked them, you too, are you not going to leave? Then Peter gives the perfect response. Now he gets it. But sometimes Peter doesn't get it. But this time he gets it. He says, where else should we go? You are the word. You have the word of eternal life. In a sense, choosing God, my brothers and sisters, is choosing life. Choosing the other way is choosing destruction. Every day in our lives, you and I are presented with a choice to choose what is good or to choose what is bad. I mean, the very fact that we're here is a blessing. It's a sign that we've chosen God. But for those of us who have chosen God, we have to ask ourselves the question, why am I making this choice? For we know that the intentionality of an action could change the whole moral compass of that action. So those of us who choose God by coming to Mass, perhaps by going to confession, by praying the rosary, we always have to purify our intentions, making sure that we're staying with God, we're sticking with Jesus for the right reason. But not only that, we also have to challenge ourselves every day, because sin is a battle. It might be a battle for the rest of our lives. Right? It's a battle that we have to fight every single day. And every day we're presented with that choice to decide to choose God or to choose evil. But we know that when we choose God, eternal life, real life, nourishing life is ours.